If you're a foul, diseased Death Guard player, then chances are you fancy having a couple of big units of Poxwalkers in your army. Well, in this video we're going to show you exactly how to paint your Poxwalkers in no time at all. We're going to use just contrast paints, shades and dry brushes to get your units done quickly and on the battlefield, spreading the Pox across the Imperium in no time at all. Now, we've already undercoated our model here with Wraithbone spray, and the first thing we're going to be painting is the flesh on our Poxwalker, as it's the largest and messiest area. Now, lots of different contrast paints work really well on flesh like this. You can go for sort of human flesh tones, or grey dead flesh tones, or even horrible green flesh tones. For us, we're going to start off by painting it with Plaguebearer flesh contrast paint, and for this we're using a medium shade brush. Let's grab some Plaguebearer flesh from the pot and onto our palette here. Now, we're not going to thin this down at all, we're just making sure we're not overloading our brush with too much paint, but we are going to load up our medium shade brush with quite a lot, then onto our Poxwalker. Now here we're adding a nice liberal coat of Plaguebearer flesh all over the Poxwalker. A couple of things here. First of all, try and be as neat as you possibly can. Try not to hit other areas of the miniature. But don't worry if you do, we can always go back with a pot of Wraithbone and tidy that up later on. Second of all, don't allow it to pool too much in the recesses. You can see here on the torso, it's pooled a little bit around here. So what we're going to do is just use the brush and poke it a little bit to get rid of that pooling, to make sure we've got a nice even coat all over our Poxwalker's flesh. There we go, that's dried, giving a really disgusting green look to the flesh. Now you can leave it there if you'd like to, but we're going to add a couple more colours here to make it look even more disgusting. We're going to start off with Gilliman flesh mixed with contrast medium. Here, grab your medium shade brush again. Now first of all, let's take some contrast medium and add it to our palette here. I'm going to take three brushfuls here, like this, and then wash my brush off to make sure there's no medium left in there at all. And then I'm going to take one brushful of Gilliman flesh and just mix it in there to the mix. So there we've got a nice thinned down Gilliman flesh. Then load the brush up here, and we're going to apply that nice and liberally again all over the skin. And you'll see it's going to have a nice sort of effect on the skin, making it look even more disgusting and grim. There we go, that's dried, and look how disgusting that looks. Okay, again, you can leave it there if you'd like to, but we're going to go one stage further here and apply a dry brush over the flesh using Underhive Ash. Grab your small dry brush for this one. Now, Underhive Ash is a dry paint, so get some out of the pot like so and add it to our tissue paper here and wipe off most of the paint. Being a dry paint, it shouldn't take too long to clean that brush off of most of the paint. Then we've got a nice brush perfect for dry brushing. Then here we go, onto our Poxwalker. Now, what we're going to do here is to apply a nice light dry brush all over the flesh tones like so. And you can see as we dry brush it over, it's going to be picking out some of those raised areas on the flesh to make it look a little bit more pallid in some areas and give a bit more detail and definition to that skin tone. Just a light dry brush here, don't press too hard. There we go, that's the dry brush done on the skin and it looks positively disgusting. Perfect. Okay, up next, let's take some Caraberg Crimson shade paint, thin it with a touch of water, almost to the consistency of a glaze, and add it onto the boils and pockmarks on our Poxwalker's skin. Grab your small airbrush for this one. Let's take some Caraberg Crimson from the pot here and onto our palette. Now, we're going to take a little bit of water here and just thin it down so much so it's really, really subtle when it goes on. Maybe a little bit more water. There we go. Perfect. Then we're going to load our brush up and onto the Poxwalker miniature. Here, we're applying this onto all the boils and pock marks on the skin. So here we go. One right there. I'm just going to add that over the top there. It's going to be quite subtle when it goes on, but it's going to give a really cool sort of raw, destroyed flesh kind of look. There we go. We're going to add it around the more on the front of his belly there as well. On all the pock marks on the skin there, just look at that, ooh, it looks disgusting. We're also going to paint it into his eyes as well, and his mouth too, to make them stand out. There we go, that's the flesh of our Poxwalker completed. Right, next up, let's paint those trousers, and here we're going to paint them orange, starting with Griffhound Orange Contrast Paint, followed by a dry brush of Kindle Flame. First of all, it's that Griffhound Orange. Grab your medium shade brush for this one. Let's take some paint from the pot, and again with the contrast paint, we're not going to thin it down. Just going to make sure we haven't got too much paint on the brush. There we go, that's bang on. Then onto our Poxwalker. Here, again, a nice liberal coat being applied all over the trousers of our Poxwalker, like so. Just apply it all over like so, and just make sure you're not hitting any of the parts you've already painted. So don't hit that flesh. Be as neat as you can here. Then we'll add a quick highlight over the top of this with Kindle Flame Dry Paint. Here we're just dry brushing it on with a small dry brush, making sure we're picking out those raised areas on those orange trousers. Once we've done this, we're going to go back and touch up any mistakes we've made with Wraithbone. That's the trousers painted, and we've also been back and tidied up the model with Wraithbone paint. Let's add some more details now. We'll start off by painting the horns on our Poxwalkers' back with Skeleton Horde contrast paint. Then we'll pick up the metal parts of the miniature with Basilicanum Grey. Then we'll go back and wash over both the horns and the metal with Agrax Earthshade. First of all, Skeleton Horde. Grab your medium shade brush again for this one. Again, take some paint from the pot and onto our palette. Here we go, just making sure we've got enough on the brush. Bingo. Then onto the horns on our Poxwalker. Just applying a nice liberal coat again onto the horns like so. Now it's quite a similar colour to the Plague Bearer flesh we used earlier on, so hopefully this will blend quite nicely into the skin, which is exactly the look we're going for. Next up, it's a nice healthy coat of Basilicanum Grey onto the metal areas of your model. So here on this particular Poxwalker, it's going to be this hammerhead. We've got this knife over here. We're also going to paint those little ringlets around his waist too. Next up, we've got Agrax Earthshade, and here we're using it in two different ways. First of all, on the metal parts of the miniature, we're putting a wash over the top like so. Then on the horns, here we're painting just the top of the horn, so just like this, start from about halfway up and work towards the top like this to get a nice sort of feathered look on the horns. There we go, that's those areas done. Alright, let's add some more colours now, and we'll start off with Wildwood contrast paint. We're going to use that on the leather on the Poxwalker, as well as the wood and also the very tips of the horns. Once that's done, we'll take Sylvaneth Bark dry paint and dry brush it onto the wood. Finally, we'll take Necron Compound and dry brush it onto the metal. First of all, it's that Wildwood. Here, as we're using quite small details, we're painting with our small layer brush. Let's grab some paint from the pot and onto our palette. Now with a brush this small, it's important to make sure we don't overload our brush with too much paint. I'm going to make sure we've just got enough. There we go, bang on, that's perfect. Then onto our Poxwalker. Here we're applying this onto the leather on the Poxwalker, so all the pouches and the belt around his waist as well, as well as the wood. So on this particular miniature, we've got the handle of the mallet here. I'm going to paint that in right now. And also we're going to paint it onto the tips of the horns, the very top here, like this. Next up, we're dry brushing the wood with Sylvaneth Bark. Here we're using an old medium base brush for a bit of added control. Next up, we're using that same old medium base brush, just dry brush the metal areas with Necron Compound to give them a hint of metallics on the very edges. There we go, that's the metals done. Now there's only one detail left on our miniature to paint, of course, and that's the filthy maggots crawling all over his body. For this, we're going to use a contrast paint, a Volupus Pink, and a small airbrush. Let's take some Volupus Pink from the pot here and onto our palette. Again, we're not going to thin it down, we're just making sure we've got not too much paint on the brush. Then onto our Poxwalker. Let's pick out these disgusting maggots crawling all over his body then with just a quick cheeky touch of Volupus Pink like this. You can see straight away, it looks sort of bloated and full of blood. So there we go, that's our Poxwalker painted super fast. And using this method, you can get your big units of Poxwalkers painted in no time at all and spread that plague across the galaxy. I hope you've enjoyed the video. Happy painting.